Eros was the Greek god of love, or more precisely, passionate and physical desire. Without warning, he selects his target and forcefully strikes at their hearts, bringing confusion and irrepressible feelings, or in the words of his soiled, he loosens the limbs and weakens the mind. Eros himself is a carefree, beautiful youth, crowned with flowers, especially of roses, which are closely associated with the god. According to Hesiod in his Theogony, Eros was one of the primeval gods who, along with Chaos and Gaia, Earth, were responsible for the creation. Here, he perhaps represented a universal love. In other traditions, he was the winged acolyte or assistant of the goddess Aphrodite, goddess of love and beauty. He was also sometimes regarded as the child of Aphrodite, with Ares and his father, and his brothers were Deimos, Fear, Phobos, Panic, and Hermonier, Harmony. In some traditions, Eros also had a younger brother, Anteros, who was a much darker figure and avenger of unrequited love. It was thought of Eros aroused, often randomly aimed, made people fall in love. One of the most famous episodes involving his trick was when Apollo ridiculed the skills of Eros as an archer, and the latter fired one of his arrows at the great god, making him fall in love with the nymph Death. Another such instance of Eros using his love carrying arrows was when he made Phaedra fall in love with the great hero Jason. The god was not himself immune to the powers of love, and he famously fell for the married Venus against the wishes of her mother Aphrodite. Eros and his omnipotence were also a favorite subject of such philosophers as the Epicureans, Pyrmidons, and of Plato, who discusses him at length in both his Symposium and Critias. In Greek legend, he was the subject of cult worship in Thespiae, with its sporting and artistic festival, the Etolia, and at Athens, Leptar, Belier, and Parum. In addition, he was closely associated with many of the cults of Aphrodite. Altars to Eros were placed at both the Academy of Athens and the Gymnasium of Elist. Eros was also considered the protector of homosexual love. In ancient Greek art from the 6th century BCE, Eros is usually depicted as an adolescent with wings, and he often carries a wealth of victory. He may also hold a lyre, a hare, or a whip, a ladder, when in pursuit of a youth. He is only depicted carrying a bow with any great frequency from the 4th century BCE, although the first literary reference is Euripides, Iphigenia, Odidensis, c. 508 BCE. On Greek poetry, he usually appears in wedding and other romantic scenes, often hovering above the main protagonist, such as Paris and Helen of Troy. Athletic and military scenes may also include the impish god, and he regularly features in scenes of Aphrodite's birth and the creation of Pandora, the first woman in Greek mythology. Features of Eros can also appear in two or three, when they are referred to as Eros, symbolic of different forms love can take. When in a group, these are often given in individual names of Eros: Himeros, desire, and Photos, yearning. Eros also famously appeared on the base of throne of Zeus as part of the statue at Olympia, which was one of the seven wonders of the ancient world, and he is present to the east friest of the Parthenon, shows as a child next to Aphrodite. It is only a letter of Roman art at Eros. Under his new name Cupid, it's commonly portrayed unflatteringly as a rather chubby and mischievous baby.